My name is Alex Goel, and I am a first-year medical student at UCLA. I work in Dr. Jennifer Long's lab. Right now, I'm organizing a clinical trial to study how older patients who are experiencing problems with their voice as they get older, how they respond to different treatments to try to help their voices get better. And right now, what we're looking at is how voice therapy can work to help them. That's basically just training your vocal cords by doing different vocal exercises the same way you would exercise, you know, your arms in the gym, by saying different phrases and making different sounds, kind of exercising your vocal cords in the same way. And that kind of strength training sort of thing, people have kind of started to show, and we're looking into more, can help reverse the aging process of your vocal cords and keep them healthy. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. In college, I didn't know what I wanted to do, and I thought about it pretty carefully, like in a, you know, sort of computational way, trying to figure out, oh, what do I like, what do I not like? And one of the things about science that drew me to it is the fact that you really are working to learn something that will not only help you become more knowledgeable, but it's also, the whole point is doing something that will help someone else later, or many other persons later. And I think science is a field that really has that at its core and makes it fun to just get up and do it. When coming to medical school, I didn't know what kind of doctor I wanted to be. But after being here for a few months, one field that really started to catch my eye is head and neck surgery, ear, nose, throat medicine. And what I think is interesting about that is when someone is struggling with a problem kind of in that region, these are problems that really impact someone's just daily life. You know, even if you wake up with a stuffy nose and a cold, it's just your whole day is miserable. Imagine if you had a permanent problem that is making that every day, every second. These are problems that really impact quality of life. So to be on the team that's either working in the hospital to make those people better, or in the lab to come up with more long-term solutions that will make those people better, it's exciting to be a part of that. My work in the lab is a little bit different from the traditional lab work, because what I work with are clinical trials. And what that means is we study patients who are going through standard care in the hospital, kind of like it, anyone would go through. But what we do is we monitor and measure how those patients are doing with different types of therapies. And after collecting all of that data, we kind of crunch it and make big conclusions about what works and what doesn't. And this kind of thing, while I don't think it's as looks as glamorous maybe as when you're in the lab mixing like this and like this, it's really important, because if you're in the hospital and treatments are being administered but no one's keeping track of really what's working and what's not in a scientific mathematical way, you can lose a lot of information that could help people later. One of the reasons I really enjoy science and enjoy where I am now is that science is very flexible. Within science, you'd be amazed how different the different settings within it are, even within medicine. You know, we've all been to our primary doctor and our pediatrician, but there's every part of your body, if you look down, there's a doctor just for that. Some people like studying bones and muscles and injuries in sports. Some people just like thinking about the brain and all of its complexities. Those are totally different personalities of people. And if you kind of think of each part and how you can study it, you realize there's not one personality type that should go into science, because each realm has its own thing. So I would discourage anyone from thinking that they don't have the personality for science or medicine. All that matters is that you find something that you like.